we shall learn more about the pullinga shabdas and their usage, probably in simple sentences, etc. And this is part of our textbook, which is in, as per the textbook, this is called Prathamaha Pathaha, though it is lesson number 3 as per the index order. So Pullinga Shabda Parichayaha. Now we have seen in the Namapada, that is in the noun forms, there are three genders, Pullinga, Strilinga and Napumsakalinga. And here we shall see more about the Pullinga Shabdas. What are the common ways in which we can use it, and what are the pronouns that are related to the Pullinga Shabda, and how to use them in combination with the noun forms. This is something that we will learn now. Pullinga Shabdaha. We will start reading. I will call out a student. Let us read it, and also you can translate the word to English, because you can see the picture and you'll be able to do it. Can you start reading out and also tell in English?
Yes, Mother. Ram, Ram, Ram.
Ram, Ram.
Balakaha. Boy.
Very good.
Inaha. Sun. Chandraha. Moon. Uragaha. Snake. Kandukaha. Ball. Alayaha. Home. Ghataha. Pot. Kataha, mat. Deepaha, lamp. Mataha, temple. Ghanaha, cloud. Jashaha, fish.
Very nice. Well decided. Now, these were some of the words in Pullinga form. If you identify in any of these words, as I had told in the first class, these are all Akarantaha Pullinga Shabdaha. Akaranta Pullinga Shabdaha. And hence, every word is ending with Aha. Okay. Similar to Ramaha. If you see Jashaha or Ghanaha or Mataha, any of these, of the 12 words that we learned now, all of these words are Akaranta Pullinga Shabdaha. Okay, and hence the forms are similar to Rama Shabda. Now what we shall do is, we shall see these words in different Vachanas. So right now we had seen in Eka Vachanam, which is Ramaha, like that. Now we shall see in the different Vachanas, Eka Vachanam, Dvivachanam and Bahu Vachanam. As you know, in Sanskritam, we have three numbers. In English or in any of the other languages, we have just singular and plural. But in Sanskritam, we have singular and dual, which is for two. One boy, Balakaha, Balakau, two boys, and boys, a plural, which is Balakaha. In the same way, we'll take one more example. Deepaha, Deepau, Deepaha. The same way as we learnt Rama Shabda, Ramaha, Ramau, Ramaha, any Akaranta Pullinga Shabda will follow the same forms similar to Rama Shabda. Now we shall read out for the other Vachanas for the forms that we have already learnt. Can you please read out?
Balakaha, Balakau, Balakaha.
Very good.
Inaha. Inau, Inaha. Chandraha, Chandro, Chandraha.
Chandrau, au, aukara should be a bit clearly said. Similar to Ramau, Inau, Balakau, Chandrau.
Chandrau.
Yes.
Uragaha, Uragau, Uragaha.
Read the last one again.
Uragaha.
Yes. Uraga Shabda, Akarantaha Pullingaha Uraga Shabdaha. Uragaha, Uragau, Uragaha. Okay. Able to identify? Able to read it? Okay.
Yes.
Very good. Dhanyavadaha.
Dhanyavadaha.
Can you please read the next
part? Kandukaha, Kandukau, कंदुका आलयः 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 घटः घटः घटौ घटाः
घटाः दीर्घ इज दैट
कटः कटौ कटाः
दीपः दीपौ दीपाः मठः मठौ मठाः घनः घनौ घनाः जशः जशौ जशाः
वेरी गुड झषः झषौ झषाः सो सिंस इट इज अ मूर्धन्य मूर्धन्य वर्ण श विल हैव टू रोल अप
आवर टंग
या सो या इनिशियली इट मे बी अ बिट डिफिकल्ट टू गेट द एग्जैक्ट प्रोनंसिएशन बट विद प्रैक्टिस डेफिनेटली विल बी एबल टू गेट इट एंड इन दिस केस बोथ दिस इज अ महाप्राण झ झषः सो in general this kind of words where which has both mahaprana murdhanya letter etc is a bit we require a bit more effort to pronounce these so as we have seen all these 12 words are akarantah pullingah and that particular pratipadika like for deepah it is deepa deepa shabdah for mathah it is matha shabdah ghanah it is ghana shabdah and jhashah it will be akarantah pullingah jhasha shabdah so in this way we have seen a few akarantah pullinga shabdas now we shall see some more in detail about this along with probably a usage of a few common pronouns now in sanskritam there are many pronouns pronoun is one which is used in place of a noun that is one and in another way we use these words also to introduce about that particular noun like we say he is rama in english he is rama he is going to the school so now the first he when we refer we are just using that to refer to that person rama he is rama we are introducing that person rama or this is rama etc and next the consecutive usage of the word he will be to say that this person rama is himself is going to the school he is rama rama is going to the school rama will go to the playground we say he goes to the school or he is going to the school and after that he goes to the playground the word he represents rama in multiple other sentences though we are not calling out rama specifically in the same way sanskritam in sanskritam as well we have many pronouns and of which we will see two important or most commonly used pronoun in today's class and I will read out and then I'll ask a few questions about it and then we will see saha balakah saha balakah please pay attention to the image and try to see what is the difference between this way of saying saha balakah and eshah kandukah saha saha balakah eshah kandukah similarly one more example saha saha inah एषः एषः घटः सः इनः एषः घटः होप यू आर एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन द यूसेज एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ द इमेजेस एंड द वे इट इज टोल्ड सो ऑफ दीस फॉर्म्स व्हाट कुड यू अंडरस्टैंड सः एंड एषः व्हेन आर दीस यूज्ड
Saha is far and Eshaha okay. is near.
Very good.
This well, and that.
That is right. So this and that, we can keep it that way or he and this person, either way. So Saha, whenever we refer to a farther object, a person or an object that is far away from this place or it is not present here, etc. We use Saha. Saha Ramaha. Saha Krishnaha. सह चंद्रः सह सूर्यः एंड सो ऑन for a nearby object which is close to us, we will say eshah, eshah ghatah, eshah chandrah, eshah ramah, eshah balakah, and so on. So that is the difference between the usage of these two words, and these two are most commonly and used pronouns in Sanskrit, saha and eshah. Now we shall see the usage of these pronouns in different vachanas, in ekavachanam, dvivachanam and bahuvachanam. These are some of the new forms that we are learning. Saha, tau, te, these are the forms. Please repeat after me. Saha, tau, te.
Saha, tau, te.
Now we will see how to use this in combination with the pullinga shabda. Okay, so these are the pronouns for the pullinga shabdas. Saha balakah, tau balakau, te balakah. Can you read?
Saha balakah, tau balakau, te balakah.
Very good. Saha deepah, tau deepau, te deepah.
Saha deepah, tau deepau, te deepah.
Very good. Can you read the last one on your own?
Saha kandukah, tau kandukau, te kandukah.
Very good. Dhanyavadah. Now if you see, saha, tau, te is for ekavachanam, dvivachanam and bahuvachanam. Whenever we are referring to the words in ekavachanam, we will use saha, which is a ekavachana rupa or a form in ekavachanam. Whenever we refer for two boys, we say tau, those two boys, and te balakaha, they, we use the word te for those boys. Similarly, saha deepaha, tau deepau, te deepaha. Saha kandukaha, tau kandukau, te kandukaha. So the important thing that to note is the ekavachana form, dvivachana and bahuvachana of the pronoun sarvanama shabda, that will go in combination with the namapada or the pullinga shabdas. Okay, we will see one more example with eshah. So now we have seen for saha, and similarly the forms for eshah, what are they? Eshah, etau, ete. If you notice closely, the previous one which we learnt is saha, tau and te. Saha, tau, te. Now the other sarvanama shabda that we are learning is eshah. We will learn the complete forms also in the upcoming classes, but for today's class let us know the prathama vibhakti forms and ekavachana, dvivachana and bahuvachana forms alone. Eshah, saha, eshah, tau, etau, te, ete. These are the forms. I will read out now for this, and next I will ask the students to read out as an activity. Eshah alayah, etau alayau, ete alayah. Similarly, eshah ghatah, etau ghatau, ete ghatah. Eshah katah, etau katau, ete katah. It is very similar to saha taute, eshah etau ete. We refer to the same number in the pronoun as well as in the noun form. Ensure that you don't tell eshah alayau or ete alayah, etc. The combination of the vachana among the words is important. So if you are using a particular pronoun in a particular vachana, in the same vachana, the noun form also will be. Or in the other way, if you are trying to refer to dvivachana pullinga shabda, then you will make use of dvivachana sarvanama shabda also. So hope that this part is clear. Now we have seen these two pronouns, how to use. We will now add one more element to it by asking a question. Who is he? Who is this? Etc. who or what is this, what is that, and so on. So saha kaha, Sanskrit bhashayam kaha, the first basic questioning word is basically kim. Bhavatah nama kim, if you remember from the first class, kim is basically what. The same kim shabda is also available in all the three lingas, pullinga, strilinga, and napumsakalinga. Whenever it is for a napumsakalinga word, then we use kim, but for a pullinga shabda it will be kaha. Saha kaha, and similarly eshaha kaha, who is this and who is that. Tau kau, who are those two boys or those two? Then we can answer it as tau balakau. Tau balakau. And same way, etau kau, who are these two? Etau, you can say etau ghatau. These two are pots, if you have pots in front of you. Next, te ke, who are they? Te balakaha. Ete ke, ke, who are these? Again, ete balakaha, ete shikshakaha, ete adhyapakaha, and so on. So in this slide we have all the things that we have learnt today, which is new to us. One is the pronoun, which is saha, when we are referring to the farther object. Then one more pronoun, eshaha, when we are referring to the nearby object. And the prashnavachaka word kaha, who, it is when we are referring to the pullinga forms or pullinga shabdas. And the same, the combination of these words in different vachanas. So this is for ekavachanam, for one person. This is for dual, for two people. And this is for many, three or more, is bahuvachanam. Hope this part is clear.